tonight on another segment of our addiction show. And here on the addiction show, we look to educate individuals about the 12 steps of spiritual growth. We believe that if you follow the steps that God has put forward for us, that you will begin to grow to be all that God wants you to be. And the thing about it is that we have begun this process, and through this process, we have had individuals that have called and thanked us for doing this show. And I want to thank all those individuals who continue to watch us week in and week out, not only here on the Addiction Show, but also on Pastor's Chat. But I don't want to prolong it, because on tonight, I'm sorry, but we got to kind of cut this short. We're only going to go to about 7:15, because at 7:30, we're doing a special show, and it's called Murder in the City. And within that, we want to start dealing with some of these murders that are happening in our city. I don't know if some of you may know it, but since January 1 of this year, there has been over 130 murders here in this city. They just had another one last night. And it's getting to the point now to whereas we as grassroots churches, grassroots individuals, and organizations that are just trying to get off the ground, we're going to have to get to the point where we're going to have to come together, and we're going to have to work with some of these organizations to move us forward. And I say us as a community, because these murders not only affect the community, but they affect black businesses. They affect everything in a person's life. So let us get right into the lesson, because I don't want to prolong that, because we're going to talk more about that. But right now, I want to get back into step two. Last week, we talked about step two, where it says, came to believe a power greater than ourselves could restore us to sanity. And that's one of the things that we have to begin to really realize, is that we got to get to the point where we're having a conversion in our life. In other words, when you understand what a conversion is when you begin a turning in your life. In other words, you begin to convert your thoughts, you change your opinion, you change your position, you change your feelings about it. In other words, when you reverse your opinion, you really reverse your opinion, your judgment of other people. How do I put this? When you start a conversion, when you come to believe a power greater than yourself can restore you to sanity, you change your position on some things. You begin to change the way that you talk. You begin to change the way that you think. Because the thing is that if you really take a look at the way you were thinking, some of us can say a month ago, some of us can say a week ago. If you really pay attention to the way that you were thinking, your thinking was all messed up. Because it was nothing positive coming out of the way that you were thinking. But see, in the midst of this, you got to get to the point where you change your position on things. You know, your place, your location, as it relates to your circumstances or surrounding conditions. In other words, reverse your feelings about some things. When you reverse your feelings about some things, now, I'm saying that again and again and again, because a lot of us use or go through our addiction because of the way that we feel. And when your feelings really have nothing to do with it, your feelings are really what leads you to do the things that you do. How do I say this? The Bible says, let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. That says nothing about your feelings. Feelings is what gets us in trouble. Feelings is what makes us more and more angry about things that happened in our past. We begin to think insane things when it comes to our feelings. So in the midst of this, all God is saying to us in the midst of this conversion, when you become converted, you got to put your faith in action. A lot of times in recovery, we talk about faith. But the thing is we got to get to the point where we're putting our faith in action. Put some action to your faith. Now, let me put it like this. Just because you clean up and start acting right, doesn't mean that God is pleased with your life. See, a lot of times we got to get to the point where we're understanding just because I clean up, I look good, and everything else, that does not mean that God is really pleased. A lot of us look good and still go into hell. And see, we got to get to the point where we get, I'm struggling tonight because there's so much going on in our world today. It's just flashing it through my mind. But there are some people that who are good people. They just good. But then there are some people who are just good people and they Christians, but their actions do not show it. It's one thing to act one way in the church, but then when you get out of the church, you act another way. See, what we're talking about is a converting of the mind. With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. You can believe you can change. You got to get to the point within yourself that you believe that you can change. You got to believe it. Can't nobody help you believe that you can change but you. I would have to put it like this. The devil don't want you to do right. The devil don't want you to be right. He don't want you to act right. The devil wants you to continue to do the things that you're doing. That's why you got to have some action to validate your faith. You got to put something to it. You got to allow your belief system in God to come out of you. Now, even in AA, NA, and CA, everybody views this differently. Some will view it on the biblical side, and some will view it on the secular side. But the same thing comes out, is that you gotta believe that God or a power greater than yourself can restore you back to where you need to be. You tried it yourself. In other words, some of you tried getting clean on yourself. You tried to stop whatever you were doing on your own. And every time you stopped on your own, you turned around and you started doing again. Because the bottom line is you can't do it by yourself. You gotta believe that you are not your own little God. You got to get to the point where you're believing that a power greater than yourself can restore you to sanity. I've been on this road a long time. And the thing about it is that I've gotten to the point in my life where I just know I can't control nothing. I can't control people. I can't control places. I can't control nothing. All I can do is control the way that I believe in God. Trusting that God is going to get me through. Trusting that God is going to give me the mind that I need that I may get through this. But the whole thing to it is that a lot of times when we get up ourselves, if you think about it, if your mind is not converted, then your actions will follow. And we got to get to the point within ourselves that we are converted. How do I put this? All the Lord is looking for you to do is say, Lord, I believe. That's all he's looking for you to do. He's looking for you to believe that no matter what you're going through, that he's going to get you through it. You know, when we try things on our own, Paul put it like this, the things that I should do, I don't. And the things that I do, I shouldn't be doing, and I don't even like it. But when I would do good, evil is always present. He's saying that I've tried this thing by myself. I can't do it by myself. Because when I try and do it by myself, my evil mind gets in the way. My evil actions get in the way, which means I fall back into what I used to be. So he's saying I have to trust in someone other than myself. So when he trusts in God, God is the one that has brought him through everything that he went through. Now, when we look at this, Lord, I believe. That's all you got to keep saying to yourself, knowing that the power greater than yourself can restore you to sanity. Ain't nobody in this world perfect. We all a little crazy, and we all a little schizophrenic. But the thing is that you got to get to the point of who is controlling your mind. And this is what we have to look at. We use and we steal and we do all these things because of our mind. Our mind gets in the way of anything that we want to do for God. That's why you got to come to believe that a power greater than yourself can restore you to sanity. Just say, I believe. You know, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. In other words, where there is no hope, there is no faith. Because faith is the bridge to your hope. Now, you've got to get to the point within yourself that you understand that no matter what I'm going through, I know that God is going to bring me through. I believe. In other words, you got to believe what the word says. The word says this: I believe that God is able to do exceedingly above what I can imagine. In other words, you got to get to the point of believing that God can take you above things that you can't even imagine. Just think, if you sit back and you think about that, when you come to believe that God can get you through anything, when you set your mind on the fact that no matter what I'm going through, God can get me through. And once again, don't allow yourself to get in the way. When you allow yourself to get in the way, you get out of God's will. So step two, came to believe that a power greater than myself can restore me to sanity. We got some crazy people out there. So don't think you all alone. And the thing is, judge not, and you won't be judged. One of the things I always want to close with, and I want to let you know, remember this, is that if you believe in nothing else, believe in yourself. You got to believe in yourself, and you got to believe that God can bring you through any addiction, any situation, any circumstance you're in. You got to get to the point to believe that God can do it. And when you believe that God can do it, then you got to believe in yourself that you can get through it. It's one thing to believe in God, but it's another thing when you believe in God and trust God to get you through. Whatever your addiction is, whatever your troubles are, whatever your circumstances, believe in God, and God will get you through. Let us pray. Our most gracious and heavenly Father, we thank you right now for who you are, and we thank you as you continue to lead and guide and grow us in thy grace. Help, O Lord God, all those individuals who are in the sound of my voice. Help them to know, O Lord God, that you're there, and that you're there to keep them, you're there to mold them, and you're there to shape them. We thank you right now for what you're about to do in their lives. We thank you for what you've already done. And right now, in the name of Jesus, we're asking that you release them of any feelings that are holding them back from you. Release them of anything in their past that keeps them from moving forward with you. And, oh, Lord God, I know one thing. Through it all, we will continue to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. It's in the name of your son, Jesus, we do pray. And all God's children said together, amen. The thing is that I'll see you next week, same time. We're going to do a full show next week, but we got that special segment coming up where we got to deal with this thing. God bless you, and I'll see you next week, 7:30.